Hello guys, how are you doing today? I know that it's very heartbreaking what is going on in the world right now. A lot of people are dying, people are suffering, and every day you're taking from the news that hundreds or thousands of people are dying every day. And this is very distressful because so many people right now, they are losing friends, others are losing family members, and it is a very, very bad moment. But when a situation gets tough, we need to get tougher. And it's not either a time like to have fear, because fear is not going to take away the problems. Fear is not going to stop the death. Fear is going to stop life, because when you fear something, it's going to prevent you, it's going to bother your peace, you see. And you need to live every day. No matter what's going on, you need to take the opportunity of every single second, of every single minute that you have to breathe. I can understand that so many people, they are complaining the fact that they are in quarantine, they can't go out, they can't enjoy themselves. But guys, please stay home. Stay home. It is very or even extremely important that you stay home. I'm bored home too. I'm bored home because I'm living a routine. Every day I'm doing the same thing. Or like, I can't even imagine, like, because I'm not used to that. But I have to. I have to. Why do I have to do that? I have to do that because I need to protect myself and I need to protect the people around me. If I feel bored and I go out and I catch the virus, and imagine all the people that I'm going to put in danger. You need to think about that. And imagine, you can imagine how much people are suffering right now in hospitals. This virus, it's so dangerous that it prevents you from breathing. Do you ever you're running and all of a sudden you're out of breath? You can't breathe, nothing? It's the same thing that is going on, and this is, I can imagine 10 times worse than that. They can breathe. So I don't think that you want to be in this situation. So please stay home. It is 100 times better to stay home and being bored than being in a hospital and agonizing. This is not a game. You need to stay home, guys. And by staying home, it's a virus, and you don't need to have a degree to help people. You don't need to be a doctor or whatever, physician. I don't know. You don't need to be a doctor to help people. You can be a protector. You can be a helper. You can protect people around you, like your family, your friends, or like even your neighbors, people that you don't even know. You can protect them. You take all the sanitary measures so that you do not get infected. And protect your children, protect your wife, your boyfriend, girlfriend, I don't know who you're living with. You can be a helper, like you help other people. If you have means to live and others do not, so please help them. Because we are in this together and we need to get out of this together. So please stay home. And so many people, it is a very bad time that we're going on right now. But you can profit of this as well. Because in every disadvantage, there is always advantages that you can take from it. So many people right now, they've been so busy with work or with whatever they're doing, they didn't have time for the family or friends. But right now, they have time to look at their children. They have time to give more love to their wife, affection. They have time to, they have enough time to spend with their friends. And this is very helpful. Profit of the time that we're in quarantine. Profit to show love to the people that you really, love. 3 or 5 months ago, there were many other ways to show somebody that you love them. You could bring them flowers, you could buy something or take them out. But right now, the best way to help somebody is to protect yourself. Protect yourself in order not to get the virus. Because by protecting yourself, you're also protecting others. You are also reducing the risk of the virus to grow, the risk of the virus to be spread. So this is the best thing that you can do now to show the people that you really care about, that you love them. Wash your hands. Wash your hands. You go out, you get in, wash your hands. Like, advise other people to wash their hands too. Don't like get your hands in contact with your mouth. Like you're putting your hand in your mouth, that's not good. That's not good. And there is also another thing that you can do. So now you're going to see that the difference that exists between winners and losers. Because winners, no matter what, they always win. Winners always win. They're not going to blame the country because the virus is going to say that they don't have time. No, they're not going to do that. They're going to profit. So now, if you stay home every day just like that, you're not doing anything. You're just playing games or watching movies, series, not doing anything so that you can enrich your mind. Because one way or the other, the virus is going to be gone one day. It's going to be gone. We're going to pass this. Because we've had so many cases like this before, viruses of other disease, contagious disease, we're still here. So we're going past this. Come here, come rain, come shine. So now, what's going to happen after we've passed it? So what are you going to become? Why don't you take this time, for example, if you're an English learner, you can take this opportunity to enrich your English vocabulary, to know more, to fill in your gaps. If you're a college student, you can take this time to review, to learn more, to master the subjects that you're learning, okay? So do something that can be useful to you. When I say useful, not only bringing you happiness, but also helping you prepare your future. You see? Because today is part of your future. Because what you do in the present is going to have an impact on your future. You see? It's going to have an impact on your future. So your future, it depends on what you do today. I don't say in the present, I say today, because it is every single day. So please, guys, stay home. If you are a Christian, take this time to get closer to God. Read your Bible, pray as much as you can. Trying to figure out whether you are in the right path or you are on the wrong path. Like, have some introspection, self-analysis. You analyze yourself to see where you stand. If you die right now, or if you are in a good relationship with God. So if you're not a Christian, you need to take time to think about what is going on right now, to see whether God exists or not. So please stay home, take care of the people that you love. And I want to send this to all my friends, to my family members, my mom, sister, and also my cousins, my godmother, Lade. You see right now, like, estou aprendendo espanhol agora. Eu sei, vivendo em um país que habla espanhol, cada dia eu tomo muito tempo para estudar. You see, and don't expect me to finish the sentences in Spanish. No, I'm not going to do that because I'm not good at Spanish. Okay, so it just said that I am learning. I am learning. It's going to be very good for you. So please take care of yourselves. I love you. And if you have any question. And to finish this video, I'm going to make two differences for you. There is a difference between isolation and also quarantine. Isolation is like when they separate people who are sick from those who are not sick. You see? So if the people who are sick, they separate them from those who are not sick so that they do not get infected. So this is isolation. But quarantine, it can be two things. For example, it can be like to separate the people who are not sick in order not to get sick. Or people that they suspect are sick, they put them in a specific place to see whether they are sick or not. This is the difference between quarantine and isolation. And also we have outbreak, we have epidemic, and also we have pandemic. So these are three stages. An outbreak is like, for example, the virus. When the virus attacks four people, okay? It is four people, and all of a sudden, we get 5, 10, 20. This is an outbreak. And it becomes an epidemic when it affects a whole region. And after the region, it affects like other regions apart from the region where it is originated. So now it is a pandemic. Three stages. So please learn. And next time I'm going to make a video, a very interesting video. And if you have in mind like a video that you want me to do, like just let me know. Let me know, okay? So take good care of yourself. We're gonna pass through this and God bless you. And a big shout out to my friends and to my former students from Caribbean or still during the school or wherever, if I don't remember. And also a big shout out to my colleagues from Caribbean school. Caribbean English School, one of the best English schools in town. So I love you guys. I miss you all. Please take good care of yourselves and take good care of each other. Goodbye.